كلا بل ران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون كلا إنهم عن ربهم يومئذ لمحجوبون. These verses from Surah Al-Mutaffifin, Chapter 83 of the Holy Qur'an, deal with the condition of the disbelievers. This verse says that their hearts are full of filth because of what they are doing. And this verse also warns them of the greatest loss they will suffer in the hereafter. It is nothing else than on that day they will be denied the vision of their Lord. They will not get that great opportunity. But in Surah Al-Qiyamah, it is said about some people who are blessed by Allah. وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَةٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ. Some faces on that day will be radiant and their faces will be turned towards their Lord. All people from the prophets to the common people will be waiting for that meeting for the first time that day. Have you ever thought about that opportunity? Have you sincerely longed and waited for it? If not, we need to grow that desire in our hearts. Dear ones, isn't it even more foolish to waste the opportunity to see the harps of that Allah's words now? Even if you do not know how to recite the Quran, try to open the Quran every day and just stare at it for just 5 minutes. We all have a system in our mobile phone. That way we can know which apps we have used and how much. We can find out everything about how many hours did we use Facebook, how many hours did we use WhatsApp, and how much time we spend on YouTube. But do a search of our mind's app usage data to see how many times have we seen Quran. Have you set aside 10 minutes a day for the Holy Qur'an from the 24-hour time? What I have said so far is about looking at the Qur'an. It is the same with hearing and reading the Qur'an. Every sight and hearing of our day is written somewhere in the chambers of memory within the brain. It can be detected by examining our neurons in the thalamus and hippocampus of the brain. But my question is there anything related to your contact with the Quran in that register book? How many MB of Quran is there between different piles of files? I have a family friend. She's a 65-year-old woman. Very talkative. She talks and walks. But she is now suffering from Alzheimer's disease. She wants to read Quran and all the letters and verses are fading from her memory. Don't you understand now that nothing should be postponed until tomorrow? We should feel boredom if we do not see the Quran even for a day. If we do not hear it, if we remain silent, the amount of Quran and consideration you show toward it will be returned to you. Allah says, "If my slave comes nearer to me for a span, I go nearer to him for a cubit. And if he comes nearer to me for a cubit, I go nearer to him for the span of outstretched arms. And if he comes to me walking, I go to him running."